In this video, we will demonstrate the proper way to centrifuge a urine specimen, decant the supernatant, and resuspend the sediment in preparation for creating wet preps. The urine is centrifuged after a reagent strip has been dipped in the unspun urine and a lid is placed on the conical tube. Open the lid of the centrifuge and place the conical tube containing the 10 to 15 milliliters of urine in the centrifuge. Place another conical tube filled with the same volume of water or another urine sample if you are spinning more than one urine sample at a time on the opposite side of the centrifuge to balance it. Close the centrifuge lid and make sure the centrifuge is set to spin for 5 minutes and make sure the speed is set to reach 400 to 450 Gs. The speed and RPMs will vary per centrifuge, so consult your laboratory procedure for the correct speed and RPMs. Once you have confirmed the centrifuge is set for the correct time and speed, press the start button on the centrifuge. Once the 5 minutes have passed, let the centrifuge come to a complete stop on its own. Do not use the brake. Using the brake could disrupt the urine sediment. If the brake is used, the urine specimen needs to be centrifuged again. Open the lid of the centrifuge and carefully remove the spun urine. You may see a pellet at the bottom of the tube. This is a sediment. Take the lid off of the conical tube and using a disposable pipette, aspirate all but 1 milliliter of the urine supernatant. Make sure not to aspirate any of the sediment. Dispose of the supernatant in a labeled dirty sink. We can resuspend the urine sediment in two different ways. The first way we can resuspend the sediment is by holding the top of the conical tube and gently shaking the bottom of the conical tube until the pellet at the bottom of the tube is gone. You can also use the index finger of the hand not holding the conical tube and flick the bottom of the conical tube. Another way to resuspend the sediment is to use a disposable pipette and aspirate a little of the pellet and then squeeze the bulb of the pipette and push that sample back into the conical tube. You would repeat the process until there is no longer a pellet at the bottom of the tube. The only drawback of using this method is you might introduce bubbles, so make sure you only aspirate a bit of the sample and do not squeeze the bulb too hard when you are putting the sample back into the tube. Once the sediment has been completely resuspended, your sample is ready to be used to make a wet prep slide.